ragazzi, prima di tutto, buon anno. Sono qua in America adesso. Sapete che dopo un paio di giorni tutto sembra normale qua. Ma all'inizio, per parecchi giorni, c'erano le cose strane qua in America. In this video, I'm going to talk about some of the reverse culture shocks I've experienced just coming back to America to visit for about a month after living in Italy for a year. For those of you who don't know me, hi, ciao, benvenuti sul mio canale. My name's Katie and I'm a dual US-Italian citizen and I've been lucky enough to call Puglia home for the past year. I create videos about food, travel, things that stoke my curiosity. And if you like my videos, I hope you'll check out the Quirky Club, which is my incredible Patreon community. They get awesome perks, exclusive videos, recipes, live chats with me. And yeah, so if you enjoy these videos, I hope you'll consider joining. I'm leaving a link in the description box below. First of all, no, the plan in this moment is not to move back to America, but there are some things that I've noticed that felt strange to me upon returning, which has been really interesting to experience. So without further delay, here are six reverse culture shocks of coming back to America. Number one, wide sidewalks. Like sidewalks where I could just like sprawl out. I felt this in New York City when we spent a few days in New York upon landing from Italy before we came to the Midwest to see family. And even in New York City, which is not historically a city that I've considered particularly spacious. I lived in New York City for 10 years and I would say that at the end of those 10 years, I was like, yeah, it's a cramped city. But after living in Italy, I mean, y'all, these are old, old cities. Where I lived, Trani, this has been around for thousands and thousands of years, this old town. You know, in Italy, it's like the roads are super narrow because they weren't built for cars. They were built for humans and like horses and donkeys. So roads are super narrow and the sidewalks also, by and large, it's a single file process on the sidewalks. So here in America, it just feels like wide open spaces, yeah. It just feels so spacious. Numero due, huge coffees, right? You've got your huge sidewalks and you've got your huge coffees. At first in Italy, I really missed the big mugs of coffee, right? Like I love the coziness and I would routinely get to work with a massive coffee to-go cup in my hands. To-go cups do exist in Italy. Not many people use them, and probably because there's just not that much liquid to drink. You probably drink it standing at the bar, which is un caffè. In Italy, an espresso is simply un caffè normale. Or, you know, you have a cappuccino or something, but it's just not that much liquid. The coffees are bigger here. They're also, they are more watered down. Like they're not, they don't bring as much of a punch. I have to say, I'm kind of converted. I miss it. And so I actually have a mocha pot here that I've been making coffee in because, yo, once you have Italian coffee, it's hard to go back. Numero tre. This is such a funny little thing, but you know, I turned on my phone upon landing, saw 5G pop up on my phone. 5G? I didn't know that was a thing. I'm just used to seeing 3G or 4G. So come here being like, whoa, back up to speed in terms of technology. 5G is a fifth generation mobile network. It is a new global wireless standard after 1G, 2G, 3G, and 4G networks. I don't know, I'm curious, any of you watching who live in various parts of Italy, maybe a bigger city like Milan. Do you have 5G? Is that a thing in Italy? Numero quattro, or should I say number four, speaking English. This is such an obvious one, but really, especially the first couple of days I was back, I was just like, Literally, it's so easy to communicate with other humans.
Hello.
Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good.
I'm not used to doing this. I did like 3 printouts of these things.
Yeah, you no, you're fine.
You're good? Okay.
Yeah. Should I wait here or pull up?
You can wait right there.
All right, cool. Thank you.
Yeah.
You know, just speaking English.
See?
Well, that's not English.
I've gotten really good at Italian now, and also I love it, and I'm still, yes, practicing every single day. It takes an extra thinking and an extra part of my brain really working hard to communicate that just doesn't exist when I'm here, right? Because English is my native language, and it's just so darn easy to open my mouth and say words to other humans, and they get me right away. Numero cinque. Massive grocery stores. Are you seeing a theme here? It's like bigger, things that are basically bigger. But these grocery stores in America, I'm telling you, I went with my parents to go grocery shopping before Christmas, and I was like, totally shocked by the space. Hi everyone, I'm at a very typical American grocery store, i.e. it's huge. Listen, there are grocery stores, obviously there are supermarkets in Italy. It's not all quaint little market stalls, although there's plenty of that too. But these grocery stores stocked with so much stuff. Of course, doesn't have some things that I've been looking for while I've been here, such as vincotto.
I'm looking for it.
Which is a pretty popular like wine glazed syrup kind of thing used in Italy, especially around the holidays. So I came back to America, decided I wanted to make some cookies, some biscotti, sapienze. I did a video about it that I'm linking to here. And I couldn't find one of the main ingredients, vincotto. So I had to DIY it, which luckily is pretty darn doable. But with all these things in these massive, massive supermarkets and grocery stores, they still don't have some of my favorite items from Italy, so. E finalmente, numero sei. Doing multiple things in a single day. Let me explain. When we moved to Southern Italy, so we'd have all these like errands we wanted to run. No. There would, without fail, be something to delay us, to slow us down, stop this grand plan we had of accomplishing many things in a day. What we've realized is you gotta go to the post office today. All right, you know what? You gotta go to the post office. Don't put anything else, no other errands on your list. You won't get them all done, or if you do, it will literally take up the entire day, which no, you have not budgeted for in your schedule. So just spread it out. I do respect this, actually. It has forced me, the New Yorker in me who wants to like go and get everything done, is forced me to chill out. It's like prioritize what needs to happen today and what can wait. And that is it for today. I shall leave you. Grazie come sempre per aver guardato questo video. Ci vediamo presto. Bye. I've got a new doggo friend over here. Hi Ruthie. This is my sister-in-law's dog, Rutabaga. Goes by Ruthie. She's adorable. A lot of you have asked me, where is Kiro? Will you be reunited with Kiro soon? Yes. And I'm counting down the days.